What up, everybody in the YTBC? So, happy Throwback Thursday. And I wasn't sure what I was going to do for today. And it just so happens that today is the 43rd anniversary of Ken Norton upsetting Muhammad Ali. And, this was, after George Foreman shocked the world by beating Joe Frazier, establishing that, he was a force to be reckoned with in the heavyweight division. I mean, it was pretty well established at that time, but he just solidified it with that, that win over Joe Frazier. And Muhammad Ali, he just wanted a stay busy fight. So he, signed this fight with Ken Norton. And 43 years ago today, Ken Norton upset Muhammad Ali. He broke his jaw in the first round. And Muhammad Ali, his wife and his manager. Sorry, I just woke up. Like I said, the only way I get to do these videos, I actually have to wake up early, make it, and then start work. So please forgive me. That's why sometimes I sound like real tired in the morning. Sometimes if I get to wake up extra early, I can, kind of wake myself up and drink coffee and then make the video. I didn't get to do that today, so please forgive me, and forgive me anytime that I don't, I'm stuttering or can't find the words or sound just really, really tired. So that's the only way I get to do this hobby that I love so much. But anyways, they wanted him to, basically throw in the towel after that first, during the second round. They could tell that he was in a lot of pain, and his wife and his manager just wanted to get him out of there. But Muhammad Ali, he wasn't having it, and he's a throwback fighter. No better fighter to talk about on Throwback Thursday. But yeah, Ken Norton was able to upset Muhammad Ali, 43 years ago. And he won a split decision over Muhammad Ali. And if I'm not mistaken, Muhammad Ali had to have his jaw wired, because he broke his jaw. So he had to get his jaw wired, which is actually something that's actually a term that I haven't heard in a long time. I don't even think they do that anymore. But if they do, I just haven't heard anything like that. But I think I remember a while ago seeing an interview with him when he had his jaw wired. If I remember, I'll have a clip for y'all at the beginning or at the end of this video. But and we've talked about this, where just because a fighter has lost doesn't make them a bum. This is this has always been the case. Something didn't just change recently where all of a sudden losing makes you a bum, and this is a good example of that. Muhammad Ali, he's the greatest of all time, and he lost to Ken Norton. But look, you got to look at the whole situation. I mean, things happen, and we see fighters even today, that a fighter that shouldn't have beat them, or maybe they didn't beat them, but they gave them a good fight, or even staggered them a little bit, like when Molina staggered Deontay Wilder. I wasn't expecting that at all. I was expecting Deontay Wilder to get him out of there in three rounds. But anyways, back to Muhammad Ali, he got his jaw broke by Ken Norton. I believe he had to have his jaw wired, and he came back and beat Ken Norton later. So Muhammad Ali's no bum. He's the greatest of all time, and he's definitely not undefeated. But you know, that just goes to show, like, what makes a fighter and what doesn't. And there's been a whole lot of talk about Floyd Mayweather. And it's like I said, you know, I give credit where credit is due and nothing more. And Floyd Mayweather is a great fighter, but I mean, he would never fight a fighter that would, you know, even have the ability to do that, you know. So, or I shouldn't say he wouldn't fight them, but if he knows that they can do something like that, he'll try to take it away, like the Maidana 2 fight. You know, he knew what Maidana was all about from Maidana 1. So he made sure that he was going to win that fight by taking away the rope game in the Maidana 2 fight. So, but Muhammad Ali never did anything like that. He just went in and fought every fighter. And, you know, even his stay busy fights turned out to be dangerous. So much respect to Muhammad Ali. Much respect to Ken Norton. You know, and you know, I suggest, you know, any new boxing fan, or not new, but any boxing fan who may have, you know, grown up in the 2000s. You know, I definitely recommend you check them out. Check out, you know, the older fights, like with Muhammad Ali, George Foreman, Mike Tyson. You know, I mean, I didn't grow up during the Ali era, so of course I didn't watch those fights live, but I did watch Mike Tyson fights live. And Chavez fights live, you know, I would just recommend checking out older fights. You know, don't dismiss the all-time greats. Don't dismiss them at all. So that's all I got for y'all on Throwback Thursday. Also, real quick, I just want to touch on this because yesterday I did a video on Mills Lane, and I do apologize that the audio was very, very low. And it's funny because I had just released a video stating that if any of y'all wanted me to make a video showing how I make my videos on my phone, that I would do so. And I've decided I'm gonna go ahead and do it. I did get responses saying that y'all would like to see that, so I'm gonna do it. It's gonna that video is actually gonna be a lot of work, but I don't mind helping y'all out, so I'm gonna go ahead and do that video next week. I'm gonna start making it probably tonight. But I'll, you know, realistically, it's probably going to not be uploaded till next week. But that being said, the reason why my video had such poor audio yesterday was simply because I had plugged in a headset in my phone, which I never do when I'm recording, and I just forgot that I had it. You know, I was listening to YouTube videos while I work. I had the headset on and I had it like in one ear, and I forgot to unplug it when I went on break to go make the Mills Lane video. So that being said, the part that I had in my ear was not the part that had the microphone. So the microphone was hanging, but it wasn't close, so that's why it sounded so low. So it was just a rookie mistake, you know. I didn't think about it, and then when I went and listened to it, I really didn't have any time to redo the video, so I just uploaded it like that. That's why I didn't have no background music, and you know, given the state of Mills Lane, I didn't want to use any of my intros or any of that stuff. I couldn't find anything that was appropriate for the story, so I just uploaded it just like that, you know. But you know, I do apologize nonetheless for the poor audio quality. You know, it's definitely a lesson learned on my behalf, because I've never done that before, and that just goes to show you. And that's something that, you know, it's a learning experience that's going to allow me to explain how that app works, the app that I'm using to record this video right now. Because I'm just going to say this real quick. If you listen to my videos when I first started, and you listen to my videos from the past couple months, you'll notice a big difference in quality. And that is because I used to use an app that came installed on my phone. And I just assumed that that was the best I was going to get. And one day I just went on the app store, looked up voice recording apps. I gave this one a try, and it works a whole lot better. I'm using the same phone that I was using before, so it's the app. But I am going to go more into detail when I make the video, you know, explaining what apps I use. There's a couple different apps that I use to make my videos. Well, really, it's just two main ones, one for the recording and one for the video making. But there are a couple other apps that I kind of use to do certain things. You know, when I want a particular effect on a video, I have to kind of outsource it to a different app, or, you know, or many other, or a couple other apps. So I'll be touching on all that. But just wanted to give y'all an update on that. I will be showing y'all how I do this on my phone. And, you know, just be looking out for that sometime next week. But, as far as Mills Lane is concerned, you know, I hope everything was at least, you could at least hear it and understand what I was saying. And I just want to once again say that the YTVC student does appreciate Mills Lane and everything that he's done for the sport of boxing. He's probably, I may be wrong, but he's probably the first celebrity referee. And when I say that, I mean, like, he's the referee that, you know, notable, that people really took note of. So like I said, I could be wrong about that, because the history of the sport is so deep. It wouldn't surprise me if I am wrong. But he's the first one that I could remember. And Steve Willis is starting to get that kind of notoriety right now. Steve Willis, a.k.a. Crazy Eyes. And I really like Steve Willis. He's a very entertaining referee just because of his face expression. So, but back to Mills Lane. Definitely a throwback referee worth talking about on Throwback Thursday. You know, I know that nobody is guaranteed tomorrow, and I know that, you know, nobody lives forever, but it's guys like him that make you wish some people just could live forever, that some people could just stay young forever. You know, he was a real stand-up referee, very fair, maybe more than fair sometimes, or at times. So, but anyways, to all my subscribers, anybody who just watched my videos, or if you just so happen to stumble upon this video, hope you'll have a wonderful, blessed day.